Welcome to Cat and Raven Designs. I'm Chaos.
And I'm Raven. This is Cat. Rawr. And welcome to another soapmaking session. We had an extra Wednesday this month in our lineup for film scheduling, so we thought we'd do something a little special. We are doing The Gay Pirate Show. We are doing Our Flag Means Death. And we are bringing you five designs inspired by characters in the show. I'm going to be putting links down in the description for chapters to be able to hop to different designs depending on what you're looking for, except for the end, which is going to be the cut of everything all together. So today we are doing Stede, Ed, Jim and Olu, the crew of the Revenge, and Izzy Hands. Look.
I love to hate him.
I love Izzy.
I love to hate him.
He's a and I love him.
I love
He's toxic.
To hate him.
And I love him. So if you're new around here, we make what's called cold process bar soap, which means we make soap from scratch. In a rare instance, there is in fact soap shown in the show.
I see you didn't put any of that yummy lavender soap in there.
Soap.
We make that kind of soap that Ed has right here. We make that. So the way that cold process soap works is that we combine oils and lye with distilled water together. They go through a chemical reaction called saponification that results in bar soap. All right, so time to get started. Make sure that you subscribe.
Subscribe.
Huh. Now that I'm safe again, let's go ahead and make some soap. So this first soap is based on Stede's red dressing gown, which everybody's been freaking out over. I want one for sure. They look comfortable.
I want the rich widow robe.
I don't think Stede has one of those. I mean, he probably would, granted, but I don't think he has one in the show. So here's the colors I'm going to be using. Trial by fire, black iron oxide, and a blend of Sahara gold and honey blush. Stede's fragrance is going to be Library by Candle Science. Here are your fragrance notes here on the side of the screen.
So, Stede gets to pop this mold's cherry.
We just got a bunch of new molds from Brambleberry. Not sponsored, but we bought four more. So now we can do two Pride Flag soaps at once. But in the meantime, Library ended up being better behaved than I remember it being. So instead of doing in the pot, I'm going to be doing a drop swirl in directly into the mold to get the swirls that I want. So, let's go. Now that that's poured, we're going to do a little thing that we call around here the Danny Swirl, after our friend Danny from Starcross Soapery. I'm going to be taking this chapstick, swirling it through the soap. Now that I've got the inside swirled, let's do something fun on top. So that's a little bit of shimmer gold mixed with almond oil, and I'm going to swirl the top as well. This is my favorite part because it's so aesthetic. There we go. All right, and your boy Stede is done. Next up, we have Ed, or Edward Teach, or Blackbeard. Now, you know for this one, I had to do lavender. Because of that scene where he's holding a lavender soap, I had to. So we have Lavender Driftwood from Candle Science. Here are your fragrance notes. And this one I'm going to do kind of inspired by the soap that he is hanging onto there. So it's going to be all black. We're just going to have a line of red because Ed wears fine things well. I'm so in love with this show.
Oh, me too. I'm like, I cannot believe how many times you and I watching that, we're just like, any scene with the two of them, shut up and kiss him. Shut up and kiss. Shut up and kiss. Why are you talking? Why aren't you kissing? And then the unholy sound that came out of both of us when they did kiss.
Oh my God. I know, right? Oh, and like, I will admit, I was talking about this earlier because we started rewatching the show again. was that I was a little hesitant because I'd heard good things, but I was so scared that it was going to be another queerbait or that it wasn't going to be as good as I'd been hearing. And I kept being like prepared to be queerbaited, and I wasn't, and I loved it.
The tiniest little container.
We have to pour so careful.
It's okay. I got this.
Woo! It's like a shot glass. Forbidden shot glass.
Don't drink the shot.
Do not drink the soap. So that's the same trial by fire that I used in Stede soap. And I'm also going to be using black iron oxide. But oh my gosh. I love all the characters. All of them.
Me too.
I love them so much.
Can you guess who my favorite character is?
Ed.
No.
No. Frenchie?
No.
Carl?
No. The Carl's good.
Carl's pretty great. I don't know. Now I'm confused. I thought, Jim!
Yes! And guess what? Guess what?
Hmm.
Guess what Jim's actor's pronouns are?
They, them.
Yeah!
I follow Vico on TikTok. HBO needs to renew season two. We need season two.
Season two.
Season two.
Season two.
Right now, this renewal is a bigger cliffhanger than the end of the show.
Oh. Put it down.
Go.
And no. Go. Oh, I'm not going to get what I wanted. I just wanted a line. Oh, Ed, why?
Because while Ed wears fine things well, Ed is also difficult.
It's being kind of a mess. Oh, thickened.
That's okay. Ed's a little bit of a mess.
Okay, Ed, we love you.
We love Ed.
Team Edward.
Should have known. Blackbeard.
Oh, man. Sorry, I'm going to have to, like, gently add these in here.
That did not go as planned.
Oops. 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 Oh, it's like it's bleeding.
We didn't put any fragrance in the red, so the red's not accelerating.
Yeah.
I'm going to go back over here. I'm going to run away.
Run away.
Run away. It's okay, Ed is still cinnamon roll.
Ed is absolutely cinnamon roll. But like the most aggressive cinnamon roll. Massive aggression.
Oh, I love that. I think that was one of my favorite episodes.
All of them are my favorite episodes.
I mean, all of them are really great. Oh, but God, like, just keep the massive aggression.
Ed, stop!
So just go right along with that?
Yeah, he's just like, there are no vital organs here. It's fine.
Yeah.
Stab me right here.
Well, that's one way to christen a mold.
I didn't mean for the soap to, like, bleed all over it. Damn! Oops.
Raven!
What?
You make a mess all over the floors.
Don't judge me.
I'm gonna judge you because you judged me. Every single time I did it.
Yeah. Because usually you've been warned. Okay. That's Ed. Well, now that Ed has been put to bed, it is time for Olu and Jim. So we're gonna be sending this one in citrus agave because I had to get some oranges in there. Here's your fragrance notes. And then we're going to be coloring it teal because teal is Jim's favorite color and because Olu wears teal earrings. And we're going to be getting that teal by mixing Peacock and Savage Garden. And I'm going to be doing multiple tones of the teal, so I'm going to be adding a little bit of titanium dioxide to a couple of those as well. So here's the question. Can you pick a favorite character in the show?
I'm realizing that was harder than I thought. Because there's Jim and then there's Lucius. And Lucius is a brat.
And there's Stede, and there's Ed, and Frenchie, and Roach, and the Swede, and Buttons.
And Carl.
And Wee John, and Izzy, and Fang, and so many good characters.
I love to hate Izzy.
I dislike Izzy, but I also love Izzy. And it's complicated, my feelings about Izzy.
I love to hate Izzy.
Fair.
What?
So So I'm going to be doing what's called an in-the-pot swirl, where I'm going to put all of the colors into this larger bucket, and then I'm going to pour that into the mold. Ugh, those colors. All right, let's give this a pour.
He's really pretty and smells fantastic, and I love it.
So I'm trying to decide, should I take a spoon to the top? Just a little bit? Not like a total curl, but just to like smooth it a little bit?
I don't know.
I kind of want to. I'm gonna do it. You can't stop me. Here we go.
Is it set up enough to do it?
Yeah.
For when they spoon and then fork?
Yeah, I guess. That wasn't what I was thinking, but okay. Yeah, I like that. Now, quick note, because this has a certain amount of green in it, that will probably change color as it sets up. So hang tight for the cut on that one. Huh. Is it the next day? Maybe. Am I in the same clothes? Maybe. Would you have noticed if I hadn't told you? Maybe?
I got it.
But you'll never really know, will you? You'll never really know. You can think you know, but you'll never really know. Now it's time to do the crew of the revenge. So for fragrance, I have sea minerals from Candle Science. Fragrance notes are on the side. So colors are going to be neutral gray, ultramarine blue, and titanium dioxide, which we mix with water. Trying to do minimal blending here on this one because I'm absolutely convinced this fragrance oil is going to act up. So spoilers ahead, but I am basing this particular design on the rock, the island.
It's a rock.
It's a
rock.
That Blackbeard strands most of the crew on at the end of the season. So this part will be our rocky base. Oh, it's raising. I'm going to have to blend it.
I mean, it told us it was going to misbehave by being a sea fragrance.
Yeah.
Violence!
I'm okay if it's not a super even layer, because it is meant to be that little rock. A little bit of texture here.
That's a lot of texture.
It's okay. It's fine. It's good. I like it. This next part is where it's going to be a little bit dangerous because I know it's going to act up. I need to move really quickly. So I'm going to mix the colors just off camera so I can immediately pour right away. How's that for oceany on top, huh?
It's pretty.
I think it looks pretty cool. So I'm also going to top this with a little bit of gold biodegradable holographic glitter, which is called Atomic 79, because the crew needs some gold, some loot. There we go.
Rawr!
Done.
Raven used glitter.
I used glitter. Are you shocked? Are you surprised? One more down. Let's finish it out with possibly the controversial entry into this collection. Izzy Hands.
Izzy doesn't get to pop any cherries.
Look, is Izzy toxic? Absolutely. Do I want him to have a redemption arc? Also yes. Come on, Izzy.
Oh, Daddy. Daddy.
You know what wouldn't have happened?
Hmm.
Had Izzy not been a complete and utter douche canoe?
Uh-huh.
They wouldn't have gotten captured.
Okay, true. But would they have kissed?
Eventually.
Shows need drama to live.
Look, you, sir.
When have I ever not wanted drama in shows?
You're just always like, well, you know, I can't suspend my disbelief to enjoy this show. Did you suspend your disbelief for this show?
No more than I do any other time.
So for our man, Izzy. Also, side note, Izzy is a pirate who gets seasick. How am I not supposed to love that? For Izzy, I'm going to be doing Black Sea, and here are your fragrance notes.
Izzy is a giant douche canoe.
Like, in his defense, like, Stede was kind of a homewrecker. All right, so for my base color, I'm going to be doing Black Pearl, apt for a pirate show, really. And I'm going to be adding accents of neutral gray and black iron oxide. And again, because it's a sea-based fragrance, I'm going to try and move quickly.
Raven really went for those misbehaving fragrances this time.
Look, what am I supposed to do? It's a gay pirate show. It's on the ocean. There's going to be ocean scents.
Just makes me think of a certain song by Misbehaving Ladies. Oh, you hear a lot of stories about the sailors and the sport, about how every late sailor's got a girl in every port. But if you added two and two, you'd figure out right quick, it's just because the girls all have a lad on every ship. And it's twiddly-idy-idy-i, twiddly-idy-a. It's oftentimes a man'll leave you broken with dismay. And it's twiddly-idy-idy-i, twiddly-idy-a. There's other things to twiddle when the men have sailed away.
That's just full of sea shanties for you.
What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? What do we do with a drunken sailor? Early in the morning.
The classic, huh?
Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Shave his belly with a rusty razor. Early in the morning. Go, 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 go!
Watch this be the only well-behaved fragrance of the entire collection.
Oh, no. Steed's was well-behaved. Olu's and Jim's was well-behaved.
Here we go. Oh, look at how liquidy this is. Izzy, you behaving? Look at how well Izzy is behaving.
Probably doesn't want me to pull a Lucius on him.
I 100% would love to have more Lucius and Izzy interacting. I'd also really be curious to see Jim and Izzy interacting in this next, like, there better be a next season, HBO, that's all I'm saying. Because, like, Jim is probably the most competent person on Steed's crew, and Izzy is arguably the most competent person on Ed's crew. So what would that interaction be like, you know?
I don't know. Jim didn't strike me as particularly caring for Izzy, though.
Sure, but they barely interacted. I'd be really curious to see how that would play out. Watch this end up being, like, super delicate and pretty. And it's Izzy. It's, like, not delicate at all. Oh, look at that top, though. I don't know how well you can see it on camera, but it's really pretty. Like, I'm going to be able to get, like, the most detailed work out of this one. How's that, huh?
How is it Izzy's is the most delicate looking when, you know, Steed was the dandy?
Steed's is pretty fancy. He's got glitter. Are you just grumpy because it's Izzy and you like it so far? It's okay to admit you like it. It's all right.
I hate Izzy.
But you didn't say you disliked the way the soap came out.
Izzy doesn't deserve nice things.
Izzy! Izzy's gonna get a redemption. I just know it. He's got to.
Izzy doesn't deserve nice things!
You really want season two, right? Right?
Yes.
Yes.
And I want Izzy to die in season two.
No! Welcome back. It's time to cut the...
I'm cutting the soaps. You got to make them. My turn now.
Oh. All right, fine. I tag you in. Oh, you're just cutting.
Yes, I'm going for
it. Oh. Are you lined up?
Yes.
Okay.
I made sure it was lined up before we started.
All right, this is Steed. How's Steed looking?
Well, first of all, Steed is still...
Steve?
Steed is still very soft.
Oh. Oh. Nice. Look at those swirls. Yes. All right, let's get one more of Steed.
Ooh.
Very pretty. Delicate. I like it. Very good for Steed. Is there any way I could have you try to shove that a little further over? Thank you.
Happy Your Highness.
I'm not that bad.
Okay? Princess Raven.
I am not that bad. Look, first of all, I'm the videographer here.
Your Got Highness.
You. No. If anything, I'm the director.
Mistress.
No!
Mommy.
No! Now I'm just thinking of that scene where Izzy's like,
oh, Daddy.
Well, here's Edward Teach, born on a beach.
Apparently, I am your Lucius.
Yeah, pretty much. Okay, so there's this line where he calls the lavender soap yummy.
Yummy lavender soap.
And so now apparently the internet is convinced that Blackbeard eats soap. I'm willing to bet he did once. I'm willing to bet he took a bite once and then never again. Just like everyone in our comments section who has admitted to licking the soap. I bet you didn't do it more than once, you freaks.
I think a few of them have actually admitted to doing it more than once. Just because you said something along the lines of, bet you didn't do it again.
Don't lick soap.
Because, you know, our comments are full of brats.
Oh my god. Cut the soap, brat.
Yes, mommy.
No. So Ed is probably the most set up loaf out of all the ones that we made. So he's a little thick. All right. So it's kind of hard to tell because there's some glare from the lighting. There we go. I'll just move the light a little bit.
Only a little bit of red.
So just a little bit of red, which was kind of the whole point. Not like a ton of red.
With a little bit on top.
Yeah. Mostly wanted it to be an all black bar because that's the kind of soap bar that he's holding in the show.
Soap.
Well, there we go. Got a little bit more of the red throughout that one.
And on top.
Definitely some on top. Awesome. I'm happy with that one. I'm happy with everything so far. I can't wait. Oh, this is going to look so cute all together.
Did you call our pirates cute?
Of course.
They are so cute.
They carry themselves like they're cute. Therefore, they are cute.
Except for Izzy. Izzy's an asshole.
Is he still cute? I bet that one comes out really pretty and you're gonna make a face like, I want to like the soap, but not Izzy. Look, my man Izzy is gonna get a redemption arc. I just know it.
He already got his toe cut off and shoved down his throat.
Yeah, that was uncomfortable. Oh, I think he's going to be very disappointed with the Blackbeard he has now.
You mean the one that he created?
Yes. All right, what are we gonna cut next? Are we gonna cut Olu and Jim?
Yeah,
or are we gonna do the crew
in order?
This should just go right through. Very soft. How'd we do? How'd we do? Because it's looking like it ashed a little bit on the outside, which is just a cosmetic thing. The soap itself is fine. Ooh, okay. Swirly. I like it.
Me too.
Yes. Oh, it's so nice.
It is.
Now, unfortunately, because we're filming this several days before this video is going to come out, I won't really be able to have photos of any differences in the soaps in the video, because sometimes they do change as they cure. The colors might change a little bit. And I normally like to include a picture of that in the video, but we're cutting it a little close this time, so won't be able to do that. So on a note with that, if you don't already follow us on Instagram, link is down in our description box. I'll post any photos if they do change color as they cure. I will let you know. They may not, so we'll see. And while Kat is cleaning Vanya here, our multi-bar cutter, this Friday is Kat's birthday month collection. So four designs that are glitter-tastic after our chaos deity right here in celebration of their birthday are going to be available. So make sure that you come and check out the site for those. These soaps, if we do make them available, it's not going to be for several weeks. So probably will not be this collection, but our May collection. And there's only 15 of each one, so they're going to be very limited.
This one feels a little bit more solid.
Oh yeah, no, that one's definitely solid. So Kat's going to cut this one on its side, so that way the large chunks of glitter don't cause drag marks through the soap.
That's the goal, at least.
Yeah.
That's why it's glitter side down.
All right, so for this one, we're hoping something very ocean-y. Oh, it's perfect. Oh, it looks so good. Oh, Kat, I'm so excited. Another.
Yeah. Oh, look at it. It's so good. Oh, it looks like waves. Oh, yes. Oh, it's so
good.
Guys,
I think Raven's happy.
Oh, I really like it. Yes. Oh, it came out so good, though.
Whore. Whore, whore. All right, be gentle with Izzy. He's delicate.
Yes, he can go f*** himself.
No, he's delicate. Be gentle.
He can go f*** himself.
Be gentle. He's delicate, ooh-woo.
He's an asshole, ooh-woo.
Ooh. Look at those swirls. Yes. Can you tilt it a little bit? So it looks like it gelled, because it's definitely a lot darker here in the center than it is on the edges. So mm-hmm. That'll probably change a little bit as it cures. But man,
He's right up there with Jim and Olu on softness. But Jim and Olu were softer.
And I should probably explain really quick what we're talking about there. Some fragrances behave and perform differently in the soap batter than others. So like we saw when we were making the Edwards soap, it got really thick really fast and we had to like fly it into the mold. With Olu and Jim and Izzy, it stayed really liquidy. And so even now, after the soaps have been sitting for a while, they're still really, really soft. Where like the Ed and the Crew soaps did not do that and they're much thicker.
All right, final reveal on Izzy. Yes. Perfect. That's just what I wanted. As usual, we have our finished bars. Very happy with this collection as a whole. We'll see how and if we're going to make these available. I don't know. Kat and I were just talking that maybe it'd be cool if we did a giveaway of a couple sets of the bars. We haven't done a giveaway in a really long time.
Yeah.
Would love to do that. In the meantime, we have launch on Friday, so we will catch you then. We're going to do our best to stream. It's been really hard to stream lately with how much my corporate job is been very, very busy. Kat's been very, very busy. We're both tired, but we're going to do our best. And that'll be Kat's birthday month collection on catandravendesigns.com this Friday, April 29th at 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. Like I said, these won't be available for about 4 weeks while they cure. So once we're closer to that cure date, we will see about maybe doing a giveaway or how we're going to put them in the shop. I don't know yet. So let me know down in the comments what you would prefer. I think a giveaway would be great for at least two sets, but for the rest of them, how would you like it? Would you like them to only be available as a bundle of all five bars? So that way you know for sure you're getting all of them. Should we sell them separately? I don't know. But this is your usual hydration reminder. Make sure you go and have some water. Grab a snack if you need it. Go take a rest. Have you told somebody who's important to you today that they're important? You should let them know. Just saying. All right. We'll catch you later. And HBO, renew that show. Let's go. Bye, everybody.